हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी श्री मुलिका देवी महाविद्यालय निघोज। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी वाज स्टडीड द डिसीजेस ऑफ सिल्कवर्म, फॉर एग्जांपल बैक्टीरियल डिसीज, फंगल डिसीज, वायरल डिसीज। दिस पॉइंट इज ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर। नाउ टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट very important point of this chapter named as to study the pest of silkworm. So let us start to study the pest of silkworm. You know the every organism is always affected by any pest or disease. So our silkworm is not a exceptional case to avoid such type of the problems. Silkworm is also attacked by number of pest and parasite like woozy fly and domesticated beetle. These two pest is directly or indirectly attack on silkworm. And some of the pest of silkworm is also attack on your final crop production, that is cocoon. For example, stored pest affecting a crop yield of quality of silk cocoon means some of the insect pest is insect or non-insect pest is always affect or attack the final product of silk industry, that is known as silk cocoon. Means if your silkworm is affected by any pest, that will be not good for your silkworm industry. And if your cocoon is also affected by any stored pest, this will be also directly affect to your final income. So it is very essential to study the some pest of silkworm and try to control them, because without this it is very difficult to earn maximum income from the sericulture industry. So let us start to study some important pest attack on silkworm. In that, first one, that is woozy fly. Woozy fly is parasitic in nature. These are the belong to the class Insecta, order Diptera, family Trichinidae. These are the general information, life history of this insect pest, that is woozy fly. It is belong to the class Insecta, order Diptera and Trichinidae. It is family of woozy fly. This pest incidence means the season of attack or season of attack and area of attack. Particularly, you know, the season is very important during the attack of any pest, and that time you are observed particular area is always affected by the some selected insect pest. So this pest incidence is very high in tropical countries. Tropical, generally the temperature is more than normal level, like Bangladesh, China, India, Thailand and Vietnam. If again you can just remind your first lecture, that is history of sericulture, that time awards give the information regarding the silk industry or status of silk industry. In that, these two countries, that is, it is the first in position in silk production. So it is very essential to study this insect pest. Second, position of the sericulture industry in India. Again, it is very important to study the woozy fly. Then Thailand also show the good production of silk. Then Vietnam is also show a good rank in silk cocoon production. So it is very essential to study woozy fly, because maximum number of the countries is leading country in silk production. So it is very important in the view of the sericulture. The woozy fly is a larger fly than the house fly. If you want to just identify the woozy fly, that time you can just imagine your house fly. It is larger than the house fly and blackish gray in color. Your house fly is totally blackish in color, but here blackish gray in color present in your woozy fly. The male of woozy fly generally larger than the female. It is general morphological character of woozy fly. In India, this pest firstly reported in West Bengal in 1880s and caused very big loss to the silk industry or sericulture industry. These are the very important in India 1880s. The woozy fly firstly reported in India. So sometime in your examination, they will be asked the woozy fly in India firstly reported in which state, which year. So you can write on West Bengal or in 1880. The nature of woozy fly copulated in year means they complete their mating in year, live in nectar of the flower and honeydew excreta by the aphids and scale insect. These are the general information regarding your woozy fly. They generally living in the nectar of the flower and they generally feed honeydew excreta of aphids and scale insect. Now, next important point, that is nature of damage. It is very interesting story. You can just listen carefully. This woozy fly female enters in rearing house or rearing site. Once she is reaching in the rearing tray or rearing house, she wanders over the silkworm depositing ovules and they start the depositing creamy white eggs at the time of egg laying directly on the body of silkworm. This is very important in the sentence regarding your nature of damage. They are directly deposited their eggs on the body of silkworm at a one time. In their whole lifespan, they have the ability to deposit it or to lay 300 eggs in their lifespan. This is very big figure. After the egg laying, the egg laying is very fast or rapid. Then they fly from the particular area or particular rearing house and continue their life. Are you understand what is the actual nature of damage? After this procedure, now actual damaging will be started. The parasitic silkworm show black scale on the inter segment. You know, the body of silkworm is segmental. Means if you want to just, I will draw on here the body of silkworm. This is your silkworm and they show such type of the segmentation. So if your woozy fly enter inside the rearing house, they can deposited their eggs on here. These are the intersegmental region of the silkworm. So after the deposition of these eggs, you know, the eggs will be totally adhere or attach on the body of the silkworm, the maggots. Maggots in the sense, this maggots is called as larva of the particular fly, that is Oogie fly, grow and 3 instar inside the host body. Means after the eggs hatching, the small maggots, small larva of the Oogie fly start chewing of the body of the host animal, that is silkworm, and enter inside the animal body, that is silkworm, and start the feeding internal body fluid or fat bodies of the larva live inside the 3 to 4 to 6 days inside the silkworm body. You can just remind. Firstly, try to understand the female of Oogie fly enter inside the silkworm rearing house, then visit to rearing train, then they are perform their exiting duty, that is very fast. Eggs are deposited in the intersegmental area of the body. After the deposition of the eggs, you know, the eggs will be developed, small tiny maggots will be come out, and they are enter into inside the silkworm body and start the feeding internal fat body and whatever the body fluid present inside the silkworm body. Now after this, the fully grown maggots, that is larva, cut the intersegment area of host animal and come out from the silkworm body. Host animal means your silkworm. You can try to understand it. In here, host animal means your silkworm. Come outside the particular afflicted silkworm larva. In search of crack and crevices, soil and darker region where forms pupation and pupation, it will be called as pupation. These are the developmental stage of your maggots of Oogie fly and emerge out as adult of Oogie fly. Means they develop inside the body of silkworm, feed the fat material, body fluid of the silkworm, and after the development will be completed, they are come out from the body of silkworm, then emerging as a fly, adult of Oogie fly, and continue their life. This cocoon become stunted and are unfit for the seed purposes due to date of worm. You know, if your parasite, your pest larva is entering silkworm body, complete their life cycle inside the host body, you know, whatever the fatty material, whatever the body fluid fed by the particular pest, your silkworm, that is affected silkworm, is finally dead. And if your larva will be dying, your cocoon will be not produce. Or if they are live but they are not healthy in nature, they are not able to produce healthy and well sized cocoon. They can produce a small cocoon, unfit cocoon. They are not useful for the reeling, silkworm reeling. These are the nature of damage of Oogie fly. I hope you are understand general history, distribution of Oogie fly, nature of Oogie fly, nature of damage of Oogie fly, and last one, that is control measures. It is very important in silk industry. The fly proof, that is Oogie fly proof, doors, window, and ventilation should be used in silkworm rearing house. If you want to avoid this problem, you are always kept in mind, this is very important to use fly proof doors, window, and ventilation is maintained. Maintained to ventilation inside the rearing house. All the crack crevices of the stored room and rearing room should be closed to prevent the maggots and any type of the woozy fly development inside the soil or rearing house, surrounding rearing house should be closed or destroyed, whatever the life stages is present in your rearing house. Collect and destroy the woozy infected silkworm. It is very important because once your larva is infected by woozy fly, they are not good for the cocoon production. So whatever the next generation of your pest is sometime present in your infected larva. So collect and destroy the infected silkworm. Woozy trap. These are the one type of the trap, fly trap used for attracting and killing the adults of woozy fly. You can fit one type of the trap. It is made from the net-like trap. They are fitted in near your rearing house. This trap attracted and collect to capture the woozy fly inside particular trap. You can killed your adult of woozy fly. So next generation will be not coming out. So it is some control measures against the woozy fly. I hope you are understand what is the information, what is the actual control measures and nature of damage of woozy fly. Sometime woozy powder will be available in market. You can use this powder during the bed cleaning. You can just spray this powder surrounding the bed cleaning or reading train. So this powder will be help to avoid the entry of woozy fly inside the rearing tree. Are you understand? So now start the next important pest, that is dermistid beetles. The beetles belong to the order Colleptemes, which is cause much more damage to the stored grain, stored cocoon. You know, these are the your final product. And this beetle is directly attack on our silk cocoon. The beetle are omnivorous. These beetle are omnivorous. They attack on silkworm directly. Sometimes beetle are also attack on the silkworm and feed the eggs and silkworm. Sometimes these beetles are attack on the larva, the silkworm larva, and they directly start the feeding to the silkworm. Most of the damage is done by the larva when cocoon are stored for the long period. If the favorable price is not available in particular time, so n number of the sericulturists try to store your cocoon for the getting good value of your cocoon. So that time this beetle is attack on your cocoon and starting the chewing or making the holes inside the cocoon. So such type of the infected cocoon is not get the good price in market. So such type of the nature, such type of the damages is caused by the your dermistid beetle. The pest larva bores the hole inside the cocoon and they are enter into the cocoon of the silkworm, and whatever the pupa, whatever the developmental pupa is present inside the cocoon, they starting the feeding or feed and kill the silkworm. I hope you are understand what is the actual general information regarding the dermistid beetle. Now next one, that is nature of damage. The larva and adult are attacked by small stipulated cocoons and the dried pupa inside the cocoon. These are the first nature of damage. They are attack on the cocoon and they can try to feed inside pupa of the silkworm. They bore the cocoon into the cocoon and eat the dire all the whatever the materials, that is dry materials present inside the your cocoon, they feed damage to the cocoon and cocoons unfit for the railing. Because if you are you can just imagine, these are your silk cocoon and your beetle will be break this one and make such type of the hole in particular area. So during the railing you are not getting the continuous silk thread. So such type of the infected cocoon is not very good for the railing of the silken thread. So textile industry do not purchase such type of the infected cocoon. So finally the sericulturist face the economic loss of your final production, final income. I hope you are understand what is the nature of damage. The pest occurs, this is very important, the pest occurs throughout the air causing damage to the stored cocoon. Means if you are just generally study the any type of the pest of any other living organism, they show the some particular season. So the farmers or sericulturist will be applied particular precautions against the particular pest during this particular season. But here your pest is occur throughout the years in stored grain. Means your first duty, that is to protect your stored cocoon from the beetles. The presence of cocoon preyed several piece and eggs laying cocoon adult in the granaries damaged mostly on the abdominal part or the indications of the attack of the domesticated beetles. I hope you are understand what is the actual nature of damage. Firstly, you can just imagine kept in your mind, that is that attack on the your cocoon, then feed the whatever the dead organic material present in the cocoon. If the pupa is live, they can killed or filled in, and such infected cocoon is not good for the silk railing. This is the whole information regarding nature of damage. That is next one, that is very important, control. Rearing house and cocoon stored room must be cleaned frequently or continuously. Because if you want to avoid this problem, you can always clean your rearing house and stored grain, stored cocoon stored room frequently before and after emergence of moth. The eggs production premise must be clean during the eggs hatching period. It is very important to clean or maintain hygienic condition inside the rearing tray. The rearing room or rearing stored room fumigated with methyl bromide. Using this chemical, you can fumigated your rearing tray, rearing stand, rearing room and stored room of cocoon by using methyl bromide. These are the some control measures against the beetles, domesticated beetles. I hope you are understand what is the general history, general information of the beetles, then nature of damage of beetle, domesticated beetles and control measures of beetles. Now next one, that is ant. Ant attack on the silkworm in the rearing tray. You know, ant is always present in your rearing house or surrounding the rearing house. They will be enter inside the rearing house or rearing tray and start the crawling on the body of silkworm. Sometimes they take the bite of the silkworm body because it is very smooth, elastic in nature, and they secrete some sweet substance. So such type of the attraction is present on the body of the silkworm. The silk ant will be think this is a sweet substance. So they take the bite of the silkworm larva. This process, this action is very irritated, or they disturb the silkworm by the ant. Can be the ant can be prevented. Sorry. That is next one. That is how to control the ant, because ant is present in any time. I was told you what is the nature of damage. That is, they enter inside the rearing tray and start the crawling of the silkworm body, and sometime they take the bite, because silkworm is it is a protein rich organism. They continuously feeding the mulberry leaves. So some little bit amount of the sweet gelatinous substance will be secreted by the silkworm larva, and this will be as a food of the ant. So the ant will be attracted towards the silkworm and take the bite. And after the taking bite, you know, it is very smooth, and it will be called as sensitive skin. So this type of the irritation and damage will be occurred by caused by the your ant. How to control can be prevented by placing the legs on the rearing stand in the ant well or ant wall. If you want to start the rearing of silkworm, you can always kept one rearing stand, a heighted rearing stand on the ground level, so the ant will be not reach into the your rearing tray. So to keep one distance between the ground to the rearing tray. Next one, how to control, that is kerosene. Kerosene can be sprayed or poured on the floor of the rearing room or rearing house in the surrounding of rearing stand. So the fumes of the kerosene will be stop the ant entry. Next one, that is lizard. You know, lizard is present in your mulberry garden. So sometime they are also enter into the your rearing house, because you know your mulberry garden is very close to the rearing house. These are the belong to the class reptiles, and lizards are seen or observed frequently in the rearing house, because it is a natural living organism in the garden. But sometimes they are also visit to the rearing house. This pest cause the serious damage to the rearing by the swelling young silkworm, because you know during the young one period, the larva is very small in size. So lizards will be pick up and feed the your young or small size silkworm larva as a food material. So these are the some important nature of damage regarding your lizards. Then next one, that is rat and squirrels. You know, rat is always present in your rearing house, because these are the rodent animals. They are finding their food material and shelter for the inside the rearing house. So rat is present. Then squirrel is also visited to your rearing house. They are also create damage to the or create a problem to the sericulture. Which type of the damage? Let us see the damage. This pest eat the silkworm, avoiding on the silk gland and pupa after the opening the cocoon. Means rat and lizards show the same process. They are directly attack on the silkworm larva and feed them. This injury of these animals is to be prevented by the arranging some suitable wires and mesh for the doors, windows, and try to maintain good ventilation by providing ventilators. These are the very important steps against the to prevent the entry of rat and squirrel, because both the animals directly feed the your silkworm larva. If you can just imagine your silk, one single silkworm larva will be feed by the rat or lizard, it is directly affected your final crop production, that is cocoon. Because if you can lose one single larva, it is equal to loss of one single cocoon. Samajh mein aa raha aapko? I hope you are understand what is the nature of damage of lizard, rat, squirrel, and how to control these animals. These are not belong to the class insect. It is reptiles. Then these are the mammals, belong to the class mammals. But they are their presence is acting as a pest of silkworm. Next one, that is birds. You are again thinking bird. Birds is acting as a pest. Yes, in your rearing house, some birds, for example, crows, then sparrow. These birds are visit your silkworm rearing house and pick up. That is, pakadte, pick up means utha lete. To pick up the silkworm when the mounted are kept outdoors and inside the rearing house during the spinning of cocoon. So you know, crow is again omnivorous. They can feed the whatever dead decaying organic materials and living organic matter, and your silkworm is acting as a worms. So these two, and you know, the sparrow is again, if you can just spread, you can visit the flower garden. The sparrow is present and they just visited flowers to pick up the some larva and larva of insect. So it, now here your silkworm is also insect and worms is acting as a small worms. So they can pick up. Crow also shows same phenomena. So they are continuously visit as a food material to just pick up and feed them. Again, now here it is very serious issue, because if the birds is continuously visiting your rearing house, you are losing your single cocoon at time. If one single crow will be pick up one single larva, that time you are lost one single cocoon also. So it is very important to control, to avoid the entrance of the birds inside the rearing tree or surrounding area of rearing house. The damage, how to control these birds, to use mesh and net, wire gauze in the your windows and doors to avoid the entrance of birds. Next one, that is very important, mites. Female mite attack on the all the stages of the silkworm except only eggs. These are the parasitic nature of the your pest. They are attack on the your silkworm, start the damaging to the your silkworm. If the serious infection of the mites is occurred in any single silkworm, the final result is death of particular infected larva. So this is very serious issue. But by using some control measures, you can avoid such type of the problems by using some control measures. Last one, that is control measures, very important. Rearing house should be kept free from the lizard, rat, squirrel, birds by using the all above control measures I was told in during the explaining this slide. That is to use wire gauze mesh during in doors and windows, fit ventilators for the maintain the ventilation to avoid the entrance of this rodent and reptile animals, then birds in your rearing house, and try to provide better environment in your rearing house for the silkworm. This is the whole information regarding today's topic, that is to study the pest of silkworm. I hope you are understand all the points of today's lecture. If you have any question, any difficulty regarding today's lecture, you can ask me in comment box. Thank you very much to all of you.